On the night of December 15, 2006, an unlisted lost episode of Family Guy aired on Fox. It was originally produced the same year as a Halloween special in Season 5, but it was cancelled and shelved because Fox thought it was too disturbing and frightening. They were right. No one outside of the production crew of Family Guy knew this episode existed until it aired. The reason for why it randomly aired unannounced is unknown. It was rumored to have been a complete accident. The episode was entirely in black and white, had terrible quality, extremely bad audio, and the animation was done horribly. When it came on, the Family Guy theme song didn't appear, instead just a black screen and awkward silence. Then after about 30 seconds a random beeping noise started, and soon a message appeared that said, September 8, 2006. Family Guy Episode X, The Black Dawn. The first shot showed the Griffin's kitchen. Lois had finished making breakfast and she told Peter to call the kids. Chris and Stewie came downstairs but not Meg. In this scene, everyone seemed either very depressed or angry, except for Brian, though he oddly sat in the corner of the living room and didn't talk. When Peter went upstairs to get Meg, he saw her naked, cutting herself and drinking her own blood. He called her name, and she started running towards him and slit his throat. Pretty soon Peter died and Meg shoves him in her closet. The family heard Peter fall to the floor and rush to see what happened. They see Meg covered in bloody razor blade cuts. Lois asked what happened to her and then Peter fell out of the closet because Meg didn't do a good job putting him in there. The family was in shock and Lois started heavily sobbing. Meg then grabbed an axe hidden under her bed and chopped Lois's head off. She took a bite out of her head. Stewie and Chris ran downstairs to escape. They tried to warn Brian who was still sitting in the corner of the living room. He just ignored them. When they called him again, his head turned all the way around and he had a very creepy smile on his face. He looked possessed. He then tried to attack them. He chased them to the kitchen where Stewie grabs a knife and stabs him in the heart. Chris appeared to be upset about what Stewie did, but he told him he had no choice and quickly forgave him. Meg comes downstairs and chased them outside, and are forced to hide in the Swanson's house. They told Joe about the situation. He then tried to deal with her but Meg chopped him with her axe and did the same to Bonnie. Chris and Stewie escaped to the Swanson's basement. A few days later, they came out and saw that nearly everything had been destroyed. They found a newspaper and found out that a virus broke out and the zombie apocalypse came. They stood in the middle of the road where there was nothing but dead silence. They then saw Meg and several other zombies including Peter and Brian and the neighbors charging toward them. They found a chainsaw lying on their front lawn. Stewie grabbed it and started killing zombies with it. Meg was the only one left still alive, but Stewie saw that Chris was killed by the zombies with his face eaten off. Stewie got distracted by this and then gets killed by Meg. At this point, the quality got even worse. Meg then took her axe and accidentally chopped her own head off. Then the scene cuts to static and the episode ends.